Hello friends, I am Dr. Talika, practicing in Varanasi at Swastik Surgical Hospital. Today I have got an opportunity to discuss some very important topic, that is PCO. Probably even in our books we used to read that PCO patients were diagnosed earlier in our OPDs with the facts like obese patient coming with facial hair growth, with acne, and blindly, silently you should take her as PCO patient. But the criteria has changed. I think one in every third patient now comes up with lean PCO. What is lean PCO? PCO is, first of all, let's discuss what is PCO. PCO is polycystic ovarian disease, polycystic ovarian syndrome. Syndrome is so many things culminating together, syndrome. We'll consider it as only PCO, polycystic ovaries. Now, what is lean PCO? Lean PCO patients are usually very thin, where it is impossible to consider them as being PCOs. Now, what are the criteria? How we are going to diagnose them with PCO? The first thing is, irrespective of their BMI, that is body mass index, be it more, less than 25 kilogram per meter square or be it whatever. If a girl is coming up with irregular periods, and with symptoms like acne, facial hair growth, it should always tickle up in our mind that there is something wrong with her ovaries, and we should always consider her in the line of PCO. How common it is? Nowadays, I find my patients being very commonly being brought up with PCOs, where I ask them to get investigated, and probably most of them get the investigations, and after getting investigated, probably most of them we find as being PCOs only. So now the question arises, what is the difference between lean PCO and normal PCO? Actually, to be in a very vague term, there is no difference between lean PCO and normal PCO or overweight PCOs or obese PCOs. The only thing is ki the criteria, yeah, only determining factor is how to treat. The basic line of treatment differs in both the obese patients and in lean PCOs patients. Although sometimes with lean PCOs also we find elevated sugar levels, like fasting insulin is elevated in them also, with higher testosterone levels, with other androgenic factors like facial hair growth and acne. Almost all features we find them commonly obese and the lean patients. That is it. Next is, they do ask sometimes, especially unmarried females, parents, mothers, they are very worried about ki, ma'am, will she be able to conceive after her pregnancy, after her marriage? So it is, yes, they do conceive after marriage, and there is nothing like they cannot conceive or they cannot get pregnant. But they should stick to the treatment for at least 3 to 6 months, with good exercise habits, with good eating habits, and with good physical activities, they do get rid of PCO for the timing, and they do get pregnant. It is it's impossible for them to get pregnant, which is a myth being created in the society ki once a patient is PCO, so she'll not get pregnant. No, she'll get pregnant. The other thing is ki, does PCO go away after pregnancy? Yeah, it does settle for some time, a year or two, but there are probable chances of it coming back. It coming back with the same symptoms of it comes with a very simple symptoms like they get anovulatory cycles, they get oligomenorrhea, they get longer cycles. So such kind of symptoms are usually seen in such patients. Now, does breastfeeding is affected by PCO? Yeah, breastfeeding in a milder way is affected by PCO, as because of higher androgenic levels, the prolactin level is being suppressed, and because of suppression of prolactin, the breastfeeding is also affected in these patients. So overall culminating, and so overall concluding, the fact is, we as practitioners, we as doctors should actually consider obese and lean PCOs in the same line. This minute difference between obese and lean patients regarding PCOS. So while conducting, while treating them, we should be very specific एंड वी शुड बी वेरी क्लियर कि देयर कैन बी लीन पीसीओज इन आवर सोसाइटीज, देयर कैन बी, दे कैन ऑल्सो हैव प्रॉब्लम्स, वी शुड इग्नोर दैट. डू हेल्प अ लॉट इन ट्रीटिंग पीसीओज इन पेशेंट्स. So there, that's all. And here I'm going to end my talk show today. And keeping it in mind, ki, never ignore a lean patient with the symptoms of PCO. Thinking just because ki she's lean, she cannot have PCO. Just wane off with that idea and do think her into the line of PCO. Thanking you.